How's it going, everyone? This is Mr. Morales. In this video, I'm going to cover bullets and numbering, how to do a spell and grammar check, and how to open a template. Let's look at bullets and numbering. Let's type on to-do list. And I'm going to simply type in, go to the paragraph group, and I'll click on the bullets command, and I can type some text. What's in my to-do list? Let's see, wash car, wash the dishes, mop the floor, throw trash away. And let's do one more. Have fun. That's at the end of my to-do list. Just to let you know, I have different options. If I click on the little down arrow next to the bullet, I can have different kinds of bullets. I can change it to numbers instead, and here are my different choices for numbers. I can also increase the indent. So for example, under wash car, I can type more items in order to be more descriptive. So for example, I have to prepare the soap. In bucket. Lather the car. Water the car down. And dry the car. So these four items, these last four items that I typed down are part of washing the car. So what I want to do is increase the indent because they are part of washing the car. If I want to add another item to the regular list, I have to decrease the indent. Now I can type my other item. Put the dishes away. We also have other options here under a multi-level list. Different ways it can look. And you have the choice of looking at those and exploring that section. Next, let's take a look at spelling and grammar. So I have a paragraph below, and as you can see, I have some squiggly lines. That means these are errors, these are mistakes. So it's easy for me to see my mistakes because this is a small document with only one paragraph, and I can easily right-click and choose the proper spelling for that word. But if it's a longer document, then I want to do a spell and grammar check. I go to the ribbon and I go to review tab all the way to the left under the proofing group. I click on spelling and grammar, and on the side I have options. I can ignore the misspelling, or I can choose from the list of options that Microsoft Word is giving me. I can choose that word, so it chose the right word, which is one. I click change, and as you can see, it makes a change in the paragraph. Here it gives me more options. I can ignore all, I can add, and I will choose and change. A little notification will come up telling you that your spelling and grammar check is complete, and you know that you don't have any misspellings. Just to let you know, you also have other options under the proofing group. You have a word count, pretty much counts how many words are in your document, and the thesaurus gives you suggestions as to synonyms. Finally, let's take a look at how to create or how to open a template. So a template is a pre-written document. We use templates for many things if we don't want to recreate the wheel. We go to File, New, and here we have options for looking at many different templates for business. You have a business plan, market analysis, a business brochure, and on the right-hand side you have many different categories. Presentations, animations, education. So I can play around with this. And here under education, I have many different things that I can choose. Certificate of award, certificate of achievement. If one day you're feeling sad, you can create a little certificate of achievement, put your name on it. It'll make you feel a lot better. If you can't find what you're looking for, you could do a search. Actually, we can type in resume. Resume. Let's do a search. And let's see what comes up. Here you have many options for resumes and cover letters. Sometimes you can be very specific and you can type in, for example, resume for recent college graduate. Let's do a search and here you get a specific resume for a recent college graduate. You can check out if you're going to create a resume or if you are you want to create a resume or if you have to create a resume, you can use this resume template or any of the templates that you see here. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.